Who's your... Hold on. Who's... Remind me the young lady's name that passed recently for you that we read on last week.
Ophelia?
Yeah, okay. I feel like she's tattling on you. Because she feels the same as before, so that's why I knew, like, oh, hey, I recognize you. Hold on. So, no, like, legit, she feels like she's tattling on you. She's wanting to kind of, like, what is it, ring the bell about you and some behaviors that you have or lack of. So it's just the... She's giving me, like, a little bit of a visual. Like, if she could, she would take you by your shoulders and shake you, reminding you to take care of yourself. So it's just like, you've got to do this thing, you know, kind of thing. Like, she really wants you to get it. She really wants you to get it. She's getting
it. Yes, she would be, this week, I could picture that happening. I could just hear her, you know, what are you doing?
Because
you have to take care of yourself. You don't ever take care of yourself. I can just hear her.
Exactly. And she means well. She means well.
So yes. Like, oh my God. Yes. Absolutely. She does.
She's bringing my attention to your eyes. Is there something?
Oh my gosh.
Like, what's going on?
If you can see, maybe you can't see. The one eye is like almost closed.
Yeah.
It's from an effect from COVID, long hauler syndrome.
Okay.
And I needed 2 surgeries, which they won't do yet. Because COVID, she's always concerned about, you know, don't do this, your eye, take care of your eye. So that's funny that you bring up the eye, because I was in the ER. I'm on my way.
Is she concerned about more than the infection?
I'm asking her to get specific, so. Okay, so the way that she's bringing my attention to it is, like, on one half of the spectrum, it's just an eye. Like, she's, like, giving me that. But also, it's like, if you want to keep your eye, honey, do what you need to do to take care of yourself so you can get it taken care of. So definitely don't, you know, miss appointments. Don't push it back just because you have work. Don't make anything else more important than getting this eye taken care of, essentially. So it's like, if you have a hierarchy of needs, eye is coming first. So letting it take care of it, you know, such and such.
Well, it's funny that she says that, because I always say, it's just an eye. That's why I have 2. She's like, don't say that. Don't say that. And I'm like, look, I'm still going to do what I got to do, whether I have 1 or 2. So, you know.
Yeah.
And then she would just laugh. And so it's funny that she says that. Because right. She would tell.
Sorry, I don't know who it is that's speaking. I can't see her. But she gave me a reference to her about carrots. Is there something with carrots in the 2 of y'all?
So they put carrots in their enchiladas.
She's giving me, like, she likes the carrots. Now she's saying that she likes the carrots. Huh. But she's going further. She's, like, reminding me of, like, a carrot-shaped stuffed fluffy. What the hell? Where is she going with this?
Oh, she's going with Easter. She's going with Easter.
Oh.
Happy Easter.
She's going with Easter because she asked us to make her a runner for Easter before she got really sick for her table. And that we were going to, you know, I was going to sew some things and send to her for her table. And she was wanted a bunny with carrots and for the jelly bean, like a basket kind of thing. But she wanted a runner across her table.
She had embroidered.
Yeah, she had a whole list.
Okay. Well, she was giving me the visual of if it's possible to have, like, a tiny carrot sewed in to, like, something.
Yes.
Like a signature from her of the little, you know, just the little
carrot. And she now has her marker in the ground that her granddaughter put the saying on there, and in May there will be a memorial.
She's asking for roses and this is okay. So she's giving me butterflies and birds. So
yes, oh my gosh,
that's her granddaughter.
Okay, so her granddaughter, that just gave me chills. Her granddaughter, I'm gonna find the. Her granddaughter wrote the little saying.
I am in the flowers and the trees. I am in all of the lovely things.
And it's about butterflies and birds. but birds and butterflies were her thing.
Aww, okay.
And her daughter wrote that for her.
The last thing that she's giving me is asking me to say to you to remind her husband to take care of his feet.
Oh my gosh. Okay, so all the hair just stood up on my arm.
Tell her good luck.
Her husband does construction.
Okay.
But a couple of weeks ago, he had an accident at work on his feet. And he had a piece of equipment run and crush his feet.
The thing that she kept reiterating, though, or the feeling that she's giving me, is kind of like in the more of a diabetic sense, where you need to look at your circulation, or especially for him, look at the circulation and make sure we're checking the underside of his feet to make sure that there's no sores or abscesses or things like that.
That's what I have suggested. We need to go to a specialist, but enough of this other, because he does not want to lose his feet.
Exactly. Like, the feeling that she keeps giving me is kind of like in relation to, I have a stepfather who's diabetic, and the conversations are always about his feet, always about his feet, always about his feet. And so that's the feeling that she was giving me, is that whole like, no, look, inspect the feet, look at the feet, make sure that there's no this, that, or the other because of nerve damage, because of circulation issues, because of and that kind of thing. So she was just harping on the taking care of the feet. So if you've got it, he's got it, then groovy.
Oh my God. Perfect. She is just incredible.